Dear fourth semester students, today I will take the second lecture of the course Production Technology for Ornamental Crops, Map and Landscaping. Today I will be dealing with the gladiolus and its value added product. Gladiolus. Earlier class was on rose. Rose, as I told earlier, that rose is called the queen of flowers. But the gladiolus is called the queen of bulbous ornamental plants. Its botanical name is Gladiolus grandiflorus and it belongs to the family Iridaceae. The flower crop gladiolus has originated in South Africa and basic chromosome number of gladiolus is 15. The term gladiolus was coined by the Pliny the Elder. Gladiolus is also called sword lily and corn flag. Why it is called sword lily? Because when you will see the leaf of gladiolus, the shape of its leaf is like a sword. Means agar aap gladiolus ke leaf ko patte ko dekhte ho to ye bilkul talwar ki tarah nazar aayega. Isliye isko sword lily bolte hain. It is also called corn flag because a species that is Gladiolus illyricus is found wild in corn field. Isko corn flag kyun bolte hain? Kyunki ek species hai Gladiolus illyricus jise wild form mein corn field mein notice kiya jata hai. इसीलिए इसे कॉर्न फ्लैग भी कहा जाता है. दिस टू टर्म्स आर वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट विच इज फ्रिक्वेंटली आस्क्ड इन एग्जामिनेशन. सोर्ड लिली एंड कॉर्न फ्लैग इज द अनदर नेम ऑफ ग्लैडियोलस. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द मॉडर्न डे कल्टीवार देयर आर अ नंबर ऑफ स्पीसीज ऑफ ग्लैडियोलस. But the modern day cultivar belongs to Gladiolus grandiflorus. And whatever the cultivar which is being cultivated in today's world, it is of tetraploid. Means, as you can see in the slide, the basic chromosome number is 15. So that tetraploid chromosome number is 2n is equal to 6060. And when you talk about that tetraploid species, this tetraploid species has originated in South Africa, but diploid species belongs to the Europe. Gladiolus is mainly used as cut flower, border, bedding, pot, bouquet, and floral arrangement. When we talk about the world bulbous flower production, in world tulip leads in the bulbous flower, but in India gladiolus leads in bulbous ornamental plants. It is mainly grown for the cut flower production. You can easily see it, the bouquet of gladiolus, which gives a very aesthetic look. When you will see the flower of a gladiolus, you will notice a long spike. Iske inflorescence ko spike bolte hain. And the individual flower that is present on the spike, it is called florate. Aur ek single flower ko florate kaha jata hai. It is a bisexual flower and both the anther and rosium and gynoecium is present in the same flower. The sepals and petals are identical in appearance, so it is called tepals. There are three stamens in the gladiolus flower and style is three filiform spoon-shaped branches that expands towards the apex. Now the propagation of lilium. How we can propagate propagation of gladiolus. How we can propagate the gladiolus? Gladiolus is mainly propagated by the use of comb. Comb is commercially used for the propagation of gladiolus flowers. Seed is used for the cultivar, new cultivar, for breeding of the new cultivar. Other propagation material is cormel, pieces of combs, scoring and micropropagation. But the comb is commercially used planting material of gladiolus. What is comb? Comb is a modified form of stem, which is a short vertical swollen underground stem of a plant. It serves as a storage organ which enables the plant to survive winter or other adverse conditions such as drought, cold. This is the figure showing comb of gladiolus. जब आप ग्लैडियोलस के कॉम को देखोगे यह बिल्कुल इट विल लुक लाइक ओनियन प्याज की तरह ये नजर आएगा. द आउटर लेयर ऑफ द ग्लैडियोलस कॉम इज कवर्ड बाय अ ट्यूनिक. एक पेपरी लेयर होता है जिससे यह कवर होता है ग्लैडियोलस का कॉम. एज यू कैन सी इन द फिगर ऑल्सो दैट्स ब्राउनिश. This comb, this papery layer prevents the inside of the gladiolus comb from the soil pathogen when it is planted in the soil. This one is the old comb. When we plant the old comb in the soil, above the old comb, a new comb arises. That you can see in the figure, a new comb of gladiolus. And here is the cormel. From one comb of gladiolus, 2 to 3, even sometimes 4 combs are produced. And the number of cormels may go from 3, 4 to even 20. Dormancy in gladiolus. Gladiolus exhibits a period of dormancy. You must be knowing the definition of dormancy. The dormancy in gladiolus is because of the accumulation of abscisic acid. The dormancy linoleic acid, linoleic acid, stearic acid and palmic acids are present inside the gladiolus combs, which hinders the sprouting of the gladiolus. Thus, it exhibits a period of dormancy. This type of bulb, if you are going to plant in the field, it is not going to sprout because these are the growth inhibitor which prevents the gladiolus comb from sprouting. So how can we break the dormancy in gladiolus? So there are various methods of breaking the dormancy of gladiolus comb, but the most widely used method is low temperature storage for 2 to 3 months at 4 to 7 degrees Celsius. What we do that after harvesting of the gladiolus comb, we stored it for 2 to 3 months at 4 degrees Celsius to break its dormancy. So if you are going to plant that corn after keeping it in for 2 to 3 months, it is going to give a good flower production because the dormancy is break down by the low temperature storage. The other methods of breaking the dormancy of gladiolus is ethylene chlorohydrine, dipping corn in thiourea, dipping corn in gibberellic acid, dipping corn in benzyl adenine, dipping corn in garlic paste for 30 minutes. So after breaking the dormancy, when you are going to plant it in the field, the soil must be sandy loam. Sandy loam soil is very much beneficial for the good flower production of the gladiolus. pH range may go from 5.5 to 6.5 and temperature requirement is 18 to 25 degrees Celsius in the daytime but not less than 10 degrees Celsius in the night. Temperature play a very important role in the gladiolus flower production. Because if the temperature is going to go very down, means it is going to go below the 10 degrees Celsius, chilling injury can happen, even sometimes blindness occur in the gladiolus. What is blindness in gladiolus? I will be dealing later on in the slide. Relative humidity requirement is 60 to 70%. Time of planting. When you are going to plant the gladiolus, September to November is good in the North Indian plain condition. But for the hilly area, gladiolus corm is planted in the month of March to April. But in the Bangalore-like condition, climatic condition, you can plant it throughout the year. In Ranchi also, the climatic condition is somewhat similar to Bangalore. So you can plant the gladiolus here also round the year. Corm treatment. Before planting the corm, you must dip the corm for 20 minutes in the solution of bevacizumab. What we do, हम लोग क्या करते हैं before planting gladiolus की corm को field में plant करने से पहले 20 मिनट के लिए bevacizumab के घोल से treat करते हैं. उसके बाद इसे dry करते हैं shed में before planting. If we are not going to dry it in shed, then what will happen? If you are not going to dry it, that rotting can happen in the field. So, a poor production of gladiolus will happen. So, after drying in shed, then you go for the planting. Planting spacing is recommended at 30 to 20 centimeter. It means row to row distance should be 30 centimeter and plant to plant distance should be 20 centimeter. Then what is the depth of planting? Aap kitne depth tak gladiolus ke corm ko plant karoge? Gladiolus ke corm ka ideal साइज डायमीटर का 5 सेंटीमीटर होता है. द मोस्ट आइडियल डायमीटर ऑफ कॉम इज 5 सेंटीमीटर एंड द आइडियल प्लांटिंग डेप्थ इज 8 टू 10 सेंटीमीटर टू गेट क्वालिटी कट फ्लावर एंड कॉम. इन द प्लेन कंडीशन फ्लैट बेड इज यूज्ड but in the hills ridges are used for planting gladiolus. when you are going to plant the gladiolus, just after planting the comb, don't water the After the sprouting of the gladiolus, go for watering. And depending on the weather condition, 8 to 20 irrigation is recommended. There are some water deficit sensitive stage in the gladiolus. So these are the just after sprouting and 4 to 6 leaf stage. So at this stage, irrigation is very much required. Now the fertilizer application. FIM at the rate of 20 to 25 ton per hectare is recommended for gladiolus, and NPK is recommended at 150 kg per hectare, phosphorus at the rate of 120 kg per hectare, and potash at the rate of 120 kg per hectare. Half of the nitrogen and full dose of potassium and phosphorus and potash is given at the field preparation, and rest half dose is given at the fourth leaf stage, means at the 30 days after planting and 60 days after planting. When sprouting takes place in gladiolus comb, when it attains a height of 10 to 15 centimeter, earthing up is done in gladiolus. It is a special intercultural operation that is practiced in gladiolus. Why earthing up is done in gladiolus? Earthing up ko mitti chadhana bolte hain. अर्थिंग अप इसीलिए इम्पॉर्टेंट है ताकि हम लोग प्लांट को लॉजिंग से बचा सके, झुकने से बचा सके. द अर्थिंग अप इज नेसेसरी टू प्रिवेंट द ग्लैडियोलस प्लांट फ्रॉम लॉजिंग. स्टेकिंग इज ऑल्सो डन विथ बैम्बू और वुडन स्टिक्स इन बेड्स. Weeding in gladiolus. Weeding is also equally important in gladiolus because weeds compete with the nutrients and water present in the soil. So timely hand weeding is sufficient. Otherwise, you can also go for the application of atrazine, oxyfluorphen as pre-emergence. Pendimethalin also can control the weeds very effectively when applied as pre-emergence and after 45 days of planting in about 3000 liter water. Now the diseases of gladiolus. Gladiolus suffers from a number of diseases, that is wilt, comb rot, botrytis, blight, gray mold, leaf spot. In this, the fusarium wilt, first one and second one, comb rot is very much important. It is a very serious disease of gladiolus. And in insect pest of gladiolus, aphid, thrips, caterpillars, nematodes, rodents attack the gladiolus plant. Thrips is a major problem in gladiolus, and rodents also is a major problem in gladiolus. Rodents kya karte hain? Chuhe kya field mein jaake pura ka pura gladiolus comb ko kha jate hain, jisse hum log ko pata hi nahi chalta hai. So rodents को खत्म करने के लिए भी केमिकल का एप्लीकेशन करना पड़ता है. अलोंग विद द थ्रिप्स, रोडेंट्स इज आल्सो अ मेजर प्रॉब्लम. फ्यूजेरियम, फर्स्ट मेजर दैट इज सीरियस डिजीज ऑफ ग्लैडियोलस इज फ्यूजेरियम विल्ट. इट इज कॉज्ड बाय फ्यूजेरियम ऑक्सिस्पोरम फॉर्म स्पीसीज ग्लैडियोलाई. The fungus of this wilt disease reside inside the corm or cormel. And the disease is characterized by rotting of corms, stunted plant growth occur, late blooming or blind plants you can see. The most serious loss is the reduction in number and quality of flower spike due to infection. So what should be the control measure? Don't plant the infected corm. जब हम लोग प्लांटिंग करते हैं उस समय इन्फेक्टेड कॉर्म को बिल्कुल भी नहीं लेना चाहिए, उसे डिस्कार्ड करना चाहिए. एंड मेंटेन अ सॉइल पीएच ऑफ 6.627 एंड वन शुड यूज द नाइट्रेट एज नाइट्रोजन सोर्स व्हेन फर्टिलाइजिंग. One can go for the use of wilt resistance variety. Dheeraj is the gladiolus variety that is wilt resistant. This is the figure showing wilt affected gladiolus field. Here you can see the yellowing of the plants. This is the wilt affected gladiolus bulb. Thrips is the major serious pest of gladiolus. The yellow colored nymph and black adult damages leaves and spike. It affects both the leaves and spikes, and silver streaks is developed which turn brown, get deformed and dry if damage is severe. If the attack is on young plant, it reduces the flower production, and this pest is also attacks the corm under storage. When it attacks the corm become sticky, shrivel and produce weak plants when planted. Control. For controlling the gladiolus from thrips, store the infested corm at 2 degrees Celsius for 6 weeks and later treat them with hot water at 46 degrees Celsius. Hot water treatment kill the thrips present in the gladiolus corm. Or spray dimethoate at the rate of 2 milliliter per liter of water at 10 days interval. Provides significant control of thrips. Physiological disorder in gladiolus. There are three main physiological disorder reported in gladiolus. First one is blindness, second one is chopal and bud rot, and last one is negative geotropism. Blindness is the condition of the gladiolus plant when the plant remains in vegetative stage and spike is not at all produced. In toppling of gladiolus, when the florets open, spikes breaks. टॉपलिंग में क्या होता है, जब फ्लोरेट ओपन होंगे, जो ग्लैडियोलस के स्पाइक का फ्लोरेट का ओपन होता है, दैट इन एक्रोपिटल मैनर. देयर आर टू टर्म्स, एक्रोपिटल एंड बेसिपिटल. इन एक्रोपिटल, एक्रोपिटल में नीचे का फ्लोरेट सबसे पहले ओपन होता है, देन वन बाय वन वो ऊपर की तरह ओपन होता है. तो ग्लैडियोलस फ्लोरेट ओपन्स एक्रोपिटली. इन दिस फिजियोलॉजिकल डिसऑर्डर स्पाइक ब्रेक्स व्हेन फ्लोरेट स्टार्ट्स ओपनिंग. इट इज ड्यू टू द कैल्शियम डिफिशियंसी इन द सॉइल. सो टू गेट रिड बैक ऑफ दिस डिसऑर्डर, spray of calcium carbonate is recommended. Next physiological disorder is negative geotropism. Negative geotropism is a condition in gladiolus when the spike will curve upward. Vein stored or transported horizontally. So that's why to prevent it from the negative geotropism, when we transport, keep it in vertical position. अगर हम लोग transportation या storage के समय gladiolus के spike को horizontally रखते हैं तो इसका spike ऊपर की तरह मुड़ जाता है जिससे मार्केट में अच्छा प्राइस नहीं मिलता है. इट रिड्यूस द मार्केट वैल्यू ऑफ द ग्लैडियोलस फ्लावर. इट इज ड्यू टू द अनइवन डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ऑक्सीन. सो इफ यू आर अगर आप इसे लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस के लिए ट्रांसपोर्ट कर रहे हो तो ग्लैडियोलस के स्पाइक को बिल्कुल वर्टिकल पोजीशन सीधे खड़ा रखना चाहिए. फ्लोराइड टॉक्सिसिटी इज आल्सो रिपोर्टेड इन ग्लैडियोलस. ग्लैडियोलस इज द मोस्ट वाइडली यूज्ड फ्लोराइड बायो इंडिकेटर. यू कैन सी द फ्लोराइड टॉक्सिसिटी इन फिगर आल्सो व्हिच द सिम्टम arise at the tip of the gladiolus leaf. Fluoride is absorbed from the air. The toxicity is due to the heavy application of superphosphate rock phosphate which contain hydrogen fluoride. Now the stage of harvesting of gladiolus spike. After planting of the gladiolus comb, generally after 50 to 55 days, spike starts emerging out of the plant. So after the proper development of spike, it is cut with the sharp knife, preferably in the morning. When we cut it, it should be cut at the slanting position at the base of the spike and immediately placed in a bucket filled with cold water. Now the stage of harvesting. आप किस समय हार्वेस्ट करोगे ग्लैडियोलस के स्पाइक को? अगर आपको इसे लोकल मार्केट में सेल करना है तो जब आपका लोअर मोस्ट फ्लोरेट बिल्कुल ओपन हो जाएगा, जैसा कि आप फिगर में देख रहे हो, लोअर मोस्ट फ्लोरेट हैज ओपेंड. दिस इज द आइडियल स्टेज ऑफ हार्वेस्टिंग ऑफ ग्लैडियोलस स्पाइक for the local market. But for the distant market, look at the figure below. When the lower most 1 to 2 florate are colored, that is color breaking stage. This is the color showing stage. For the distant market, you have to harvest at this stage. And florate open acropetally as I have discussed earlier. Yield of gladiolus. From flower spike and comb in gladiolus, the yield depends upon the variety, comb size, planting density and the management practices. When we plant the gladiolus comb at a spacing of 30 to 20 centimeter, 150,000 marketable spikes are produced per hectare. And from 1 hectare of the field, 3.5 lakh comb is obtained. एज आई हैव टोल्ड अर्लियर, एक कॉम से दो तीन कॉम नए कॉम बनते हैं. सो द मल्टीप्लीकेशन रेट गोज टू ट्वाइस और थ्राइस. सो फ्रॉम वन हेक्टेयर फील्ड ऑफ कॉम यू कैन गेट 3.5 lakh कॉम्स. इन वन हेक्टेयर फील्ड जनरली 1.5 to 1.6 lakh बल्ब्स आर रिक्वायर्ड. ग्लैडुलस कॉम इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो फ्रॉम दिस 3.5 lakh कॉम इज प्रोड्यूस्ड. दिस आर द वेरियस क्राइटेरिया दैट इज आइडियल फॉर द ग्लैडुलस एज अ कट फ्लावर. That spike length should be over 96 centimeter. Number of florets should be over 15. Number of florets should open at a time should be 5. Like that. Now the grade of gladiolus spike in international market. अगर आप ग्लैडियोलस को के स्पाइक को इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में सेल करना चाहते हो तो इसके स्पाइक को चार भाग में कैटेगराइज किया गया है. फैंसी, स्पेशल, स्टैंडर्ड, यूटिलिटी. आफ्टर हार्वेस्टिंग ऑफ द ग्लैडियोलस स्पाइक इट इज ग्रेडेड in these four categories depending on the spike length and number of florets. In fancy grade, spike length should be more than 107 centimeter and floret must be 16, minimum 16. In special grade, 96 to 107 centimeter is preferred and number of florets should be 14. In standard grade, 81 to 96 centimeter spike length should be preferred and number of florets should be 12. In utility grade, spike length is less than 81 and number of florets is 10. These are the number of varieties released or developed in gladiolus, in which the Cartago, Eurovision, Priscilla, Nova, Peter Pierce, these are all the introduced variety of gladiolus. The gladiolus was first introduced in India in 16th century by the Britishers only. Some of the varieties or a number of variety you can say has been developed in India, in which the IARI New Delhi has developed the gladiolus variety like Pusa Manmohak, Pusa Red Valentine, Pusa Vidushi, Push, and a new variety has been released in the 2020 in this year only, that is Pusa Shanti. Arka Naveen, Arka Gold, Arka Amar, Arka Kesar is the IHR variety. Dheeraj is the Fusarium Wilt Resistant variety. And the fragrant variety is the Sagar. One variety that is Sobha has been produced by the mutation. More than 150 cultivar has been developed by the governor of Himachal Pradesh. His name is Bajrang Bahadur Singh Bhadri. He has developed more than 150 varieties of gladiolus. He is a renowned person in the gladiolus. This is the figure of picture of Pusa Manmohak, Pusa Vidushi, Pusa Red Valentine, Pusa Kiran, Pusa Subham, Pusa Unnati, Pusa Srijana, Arka Gold, Arka Amar. Harvesting, curing, grading and storage of corm. We have harvested the gladiolus spike, but the corm is still in the field. When you harvest the gladiolus spike, leave the 4 to 5 leaves intact in the plant. जब आप ग्लैडियोलस के स्पाइक को हार्वेस्ट करते हो, 4 से 5 लीफ प्लांट में रहना चाहिए. वाई वाई इट इज सो? फॉर द फोटोसिंथेसिस प्रोसेस, सो दैट सिंथेट्स कार्बोहाइड्रेट शुड एक्यूमुलेट इन द ग्लैडियोलस फॉर्म. दैट इज फॉर द प्रॉपर फॉर्म डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द ग्लैडियोलस. After harvesting of the gladiolus spike, these forms are ready for lifting during March to April. When the plant starts showing or turning yellow, withhold irrigation for few days, then only the harvesting of corm and cornmeal should be done. And after harvesting of the corm, curing is the essential operation that is done in the gladiolus. After harvesting, the gladiolus corm is kept in the shady place and well ventilated area for the 15 days. For curing, a layer of corm should not exceed 3, which may be cured for 5 weeks at 21 degrees Celsius. Cleaning, grading and storage. After curing, cleaning of the corm and cornmeal is done. It is treated with the bevacizumab to prevent it from the insect pest and disease from the during the storage. Corms are stored in the perforated tray in a well-ventilated, cool and dark room, and cornmeals are stored in plastic tray. When you are storing the corm and cornmeals, you have to keep on turning the corms and cornmeals periodically because to prevent the gladiolus corm from rotting. Due to poor aeration, rotting in corms arise. So prevent it from rotting, we have to keep on turning periodically. Thank you.